it's Ann Zuraw. I'm in Greensboro, North Carolina, and today we're going to talk about one of the positives about getting divorced, and that is you become your executive decision maker. I am a certified financial planner, chartered financial analyst, and I'm with Zuraw Financial Advisors. Hey, I can't pronounce it, but if you guys want to say your name and where you're from, and if you have any questions about divorce, financial planning, that's what we're talking about today. And today is, and I'll just do my disclosure because every time I've tried to do it, it went away. There's my disclosure, which says basically that you should talk to your own personal advisors, but that I'm here to answer questions today, and let's get started. Okay, welcome. I'm Ann Zuraw, and I did the hashtag winter, so you can do snowflakes, which is fun. And today we're going to talk about one of the positives about getting divorced, which nobody really likes to ever admit that it's going to be a positive, but I've seen a lot of people get on the other side of it, and they're just a lot happier. And so one of the biggest issues that I see with couples, partners, is that one's a saver and one's a spender. And so when you get divorced, whatever you naturally are, whether you're the saver or the spender, there's no right or wrong, that just knowing how to manage it, that you actually get full control. And that's a positive. And so that's what I said, you're the executive decision maker. I have a blog that we've been doing. This was done, a post we wrote in 2011, 5 years ago, if you can believe it. And seen a lot of people go through divorce since then, and they're happy and moved on with their life, and they're making their own decisions. And so what are those decisions that really need to be made up front? Is this live out there? Okay. let's get started. So the first decision would be looking at your finances and how you're going to spend your money, your budget. And when you went through the divorce, you probably had to talk about all that. So really being conscious of these are your bills, you can't blame it on anybody else now. And that goes for your kids too. Your kids, I know everybody loves their kids, but you know, let's be reasonable about what you're spending on them and be conscious of it. So how much of your money is going to your kids, and how much is it going to your own retirement and being saved and you know, not being overboard. So that's one issue, the kids. Are you financially independent? Do you have your own job? Do you have your own income? Are you able to put money in retirement? And that money in retirement is now all yours now that you're divorced. You don't have to divide it. And so that's exciting. So you can look at it that way. And you also have to be realistic about your financial situation. Again, that's getting help. So I would suggest if you didn't like your CPA, if you didn't like your advisors before, that you get to go hire new ones. You get to go interview. And one subject that you really need to address early on is healthcare power of attorney, talking to a lawyer, getting that done, and also the will, changing all your beneficiaries on your accounts, and you know, really getting things done. So is anybody out there? I just show one person, which seems a little off. Do you wanna just text me back or say whether it's live? That would be great. Again, I'm Ann Zuraw. I'm a certified financial planner in Greensboro, North Carolina with Zuraw Financial Advisors, and just really wanted to talk about, okay, there's a new one. Thank you. Hey, Shabazz Barira, welcome. We're talking about one of the positives about being divorced, that you get to make your own decisions. And I think actually sometimes if somebody's not second guessing you, you might make better decisions. So, and you get to choose your advisors, and you can move on. So you know, you shouldn't have to be dependent on somebody else to tell you how to spend your money and how you can have your own vacations. You can buy the car you want. You can live the way you want. You don't have that negativity, if there's been negativity, and you really can feel good about yourself, about your accomplishments. So I really want to encourage you those decisions to make with confidence, and to use therapists, financial advisors, insurance agents to really help you in making the decisions. Divorce is a major life change, but being independent and making good decisions is something you can be proud of. We have a book that's available. It's Divorce Dilemmas. It's an ebook. It's free. It's on our site, chickschatandchange.com. So please go take a look at it. There's, I know, a lot of decisions to be made when you're going through divorce, but they don't all have to be difficult, and they can be actually positive. So I'm going to share Hazel and Hattie, since we don't really have a lot of people. This is Hattie. I don't see Hattie. There's Hattie, my bulldog. That's Hattie. And this is Hazel. Hazy. She's smelling. Anyway, we lost the one person who was on, but thanks for listening, and I hope you guys have a great rest of the weekend. I know it's almost over, and I'll talk to you tomorrow. Thanks. Bye.